Welcome. Today I will explain about current transformer, its use, types, specification and test. Current transformer is also called CT. You are seeing 1, 2, 3, 4. I have total 11 and total 3 sheets. This is 1 of 3. CT is basically an instrument transformer which produces current in secondary proportional to primary. Generally, secondary turns will be more than primary, and when turn is more, current will be less and voltage will be more. So if these turns are more than this, we will get less current. If our current is 10, we will get only 1. Or we can say we will get more voltage. So this is basically a step of transformer. But this is not the rule that primary current should be more, secondary should be less. It can be reverse also. I have used that, I will tell later. Now IP is primary current. NP is primary turns, IS is secondary current, NS is secondary turns. So ampere turns of primary is IPNP equal to ampere turns of secondary. And this is primary winding, this is secondary winding, this is core. Here we have a CT of ratio 10 is to 1. 10 is to 1 means if primary current is 10 ampere, secondary current will be 1 ampere, and turn ratio will be reversed, 10 is to 1. Secondary turn will be more. If turn is more, current is less. Because here current is less, here turns are more. And we have connected a resistor across secondary. Now when 10 ampere is flowing here, 1 ampere will flow here. Suppose we connect a R equal to 1 ohm, so 1 ampere into 1 ohm is equal to 1 volt. We will get 1 volt here across this. If we connect 10 ohm, so 10 ohm into 1 ampere will get 10 volt. In this case, when this is 10 volt, primary voltage will be 1 because ratio is 10 is to 1. Current is this side. 10 times more, voltage is this side, 10 times more. So when this voltage is 10, you will get 1 volt here. Suppose this resistor is 100 ohm, you get 1 ampere into 100 ohm, 100 volt. And primary voltage will be 10 volt, 10 times less. Here it will be 10 volt. If this R is 1 kilo ohm, you will get 1 ampere into 1 kilo ohm, means 1 kilo volt. And primary voltage will be here 100 volt. You are seeing as we are increasing resistance, voltage across this is increasing. If you increase R further or keep it open, then very high voltage will come here because R will very high. In that case, a flashover may occur or CT may fail. That is why the value of R here is limited. It cannot be more than certain value. That is called the burden. And CT secondary is never kept open. Here, same CT I have used in the reverse way. This is same CT. But this winding, secondary winding, I have connected in primary. And primary winding I have connected to secondary. So here current was coming down, its current is going up. CT is used in this way also. In one project, for testing of my control, I have to test my control in a simulator. In that case, this current was very low, milliampere. I wanted more current, so I have used CT in reverse way. But in this case, if you use CT in reverse, accuracy will be less. But if we have special CT, which is designed for this way, primary heater is more than secondary, then you will get high accuracy. This is equivalent circuit of the CT, and this is basic magnetic core circuit. This is core, and this is primary winding, this is secondary winding. This primary current, secondary current. When current flows in this, some flux has to flow, otherwise you will not get current here. This flux requires some magnetizing current, that is called IM, that I have shown here. And there will be loss in this core. That equivalent of that loss is shown here, RC, resistance core. It is equivalent, or current flowing IC, core current, core loss current. This is primary current, and this is secondary current. When we draw equivalent circuit, we don't draw 10 is to 1 or 1 is to 10, we draw 1 is to 1. The ZW is the impedance of winding secondary and primary both. So this is primary current. This primary current will go like this, some portion will go like this, some portion will go like this. This is secondary current. So primary current equal to this current plus this current plus this current. Because of these three things, IC will not be in proportional to this. There will be error and there will be phase shift. This is second sheet of three. So far we were talking about a normal typical CT, but there are summation CT available. This CT will have many primary. Here I have shown two, there may be more than two. And secondary will be one. And secondary current will show the summation of all currents. And ampere turn of total primary will be equal to ampere turn of secondary. Like here, IP1 into NP1 plus IP2 into NP2 is equal to ISNS. Then there are CT available with many secondaries. Primary will be one. Suppose we require metering in many places, same current we want to display in many places, that time this kind of CT are used. Now we come to applications. First application is measuring current metering. We connect 1 ampere here, it will indicate the current flowing in the primary or some of the primaries. Second is protections. Sometime we have to protect the system from overcurrent or undercurrent here. So this will go to one protection relay. That protection relay will protect the system. Now controls. Suppose you want to control power factor or some other parameter. So this CT output will go to control. Here one CT is shown. Here I have connected one varistor and here one load resistance. Job of this is to protect circuits. Suppose some high voltage surge will come here, then this will protect. When current flows here, secondary current will flow like this. It will not go here because this is high resistance. So this current multiplied by this resistance, there will be voltage drop here. For this drop, voltage will not be equal to this current because CT ratio will have some error and this resistance also has some tolerance. So we use calibration, that is called the current ratio calibration for control application. This voltage output will go to one amplifier. It has one resistance here, variable resistance, and we can change the value of this and get the required ratio of this current and this voltage accurately. Then isolation. Sometime we don't want ratio 10:1 or 1:10. Whatever current here, same thing can be used. But suppose this is high voltage, then this cannot go directly to IC. So we use CT of 1:1 ratio, but only for isolation purpose. Then power supply at high voltage. Suppose there is a very high voltage like 220 kV. We want power supply there. How to get that? Then CT use. The CT shown here has one primary turn that is called bus. I will tell later in next sheet. And this is secondary. When current flows here, current flow here, this will go to circuit and we will get voltage here. So this way, at high voltage, we can generate the power supply of whatever value we want. This is sheet 3, last sheet. Now these are the typical specifications which we have to ask when we order some CT. We should tell what is system voltage, 11 kV or 100 kV or 1 kV. We should tell the ratio of CT, primary and secondary, 100:1 or some other figure. Then we should know VA rating, this is called Walden also, 10 VA I have written here. Then we have to tell frequency also, 50 Hz plus tolerance also. Lower the frequency, bigger the size of this core will be. Then we will tell accuracy like class 1. Class 1 means 1% accuracy at rated Walden. Then we have to tell ambient temperature, 70 degree or some other. Industrial grade CT will have 70 degree ambient. You can tell 50 or 45 if you want to use for commercial application. Then short time rating, 20 kilo ampere per 1 second. What happens if there is some short circuit or fault in the system, then heavy current flows. That heavy current will flow in this winding, primary winding. Our CT should not fail. So the CT should be able to take short time rating current. I have written 20 kiloampere, it may be something else also. Then standard, there are various standards are available, Indian standard, international standard. We have to tell which standard will be followed. Then type, there are three types of CT, wound, window or bar. This is wound type, this is bar type, this is window type. In wound type, one core will be there, and there will be primary winding, there will be secondary winding. In bar type, there will be a ring core, secondary winding will be there, and primary there will no winding but only bar. This is equivalent to one turn. And wire will come here and from here it will go. In window type, these are same, only difference is here one bar will be there, here there will not be any bar. The cable itself will come and go. These are used for high voltage, high current application. This is used for low voltage, low current application. Then we have to tell indoor or outdoor. Generally this CT will be outdoor. This is indoor. Suppose you write outdoor, then CT should be made waterproof and sunlight proof. Then terminal type, what type connection we want here, what size of hole will be here. Then test, what are the tests we have to do, or any other special requirement we have to write. Here I have shown this much, but in industry, specification will run in many pages. Now we come to test, routing and type. Suppose we buy 100 CT, then routing tests are those which are done in all 100 CTs. And type tests are those which are done only in one or two CT. First accuracy test, we have written here accuracy class 1 and ratio this, so we check whether it is meeting 1% tolerance or not. Then we check insulation test. This is 11 kV, so we have to check whether 11 kV it can take or not. Generally voltage apply here will be much more than this. For example, if it is 230 volt, voltage apply will be 2.5 kV for few minutes. Then temperature rise test. If it is 100 by 1 ampere, we will give full 100 ampere here and full load here and check whether it is becoming hot or not or how much temperature is rising. That is called temperature rise test. Then short time current test. Here, suppose we write this, then we have to give 20 kilo ampere in the primary for 1 second and see whether the CT is working or not, it is failing or not. Then terminal marking and polarity means it is marked properly, this primary and this is secondary, this terminal 1, this is terminal 2, like that. Today this much only.